You know, I don't know what I expect from these chapters anymore. It's very disheartening to feel like I'm doing the same thing every month. It's all very redundant, it's not moving forward, and... Wait a minute, is Shaoran finally going to confess to Sakura? Oh, be still, my quivering heart! No, seriously, chill out. We're not getting that conversation until next chapter. But, let's not get out of sorts. I'm sure there's lots of things to talk about in this chapter if we keep positive, like Sakura's new card, Blade, which is the first card she's captured since she took a break from card capturing back in Chapter 23. It's a return to form for clear cards that are based on cloud cards, but better, because obviously one sword wasn't good enough, now we have two, and I can't wait for Tomoyo to make a black coat for Sakura and she learns to do the Starburst stream. Sakura also picks up the repair card, and this is probably the fastest a clear card has ever appeared in response to a problem in Sakura's life, because the ink on Blade isn't even dry by the time Sakura gets back to class, sees the curtains are ripped, something that everyone in the class has missed because Tomoyo is just so captivating, and suddenly there's a new card there to solve the problem, which suspiciously looks like Tomoyo, as keen readers have noticed. Actually, let's take a moment to look at that, because that's a thing that clear cards seem to be doing. It's been pointed out that Appear has curls like Akiho, and Struggle looked a bit like Mei Ling. Now, at the time, I didn't think Struggle looking like Mei Ling mattered, because I just figured all fighting cards had pigtails and hair bunches, but now it appears that it was definitely intentional, so I'm curious where we're going with this, and if we're eventually going to get a male card when one is made out of Shaoran. Moving on, once we get to the end of this chapter, we see Ariel is still recovering from his confrontation with Kaito, which feels like it was a long time ago, but remember, in manga time, that was practically yesterday. There's a little nugget of information about how Kaito's main job in the Magician's Guild was to reverse time, which is something he was quite good at, if you've forgotten. But there's no time to dwell on that, because Ariel realizes that even though he's a tertiary character at best, he used to be important, and only now that Kaito is cutting off his Wi-Fi will he finally step up and contribute. So with that said, I look forward to Ariel appearing again in 5 months. So yeah, we're starting off the new year with two plot points that won't be resolved until at least the next chapter. Flip a coin at which one is not going to be resolved. Hint, it's obviously going to be Ariel, because the one with Shaoran has already started, and the next chapter will probably pick up in the middle of that conversation. The harder thing to predict is what Sakura's reaction is going to be. Shock? Probably. Cry? Possibly. Slap him? Pretty unlikely, but not impossible. I think at this point I just want to see something bad happen to Shaoran, because it's what he deserves. That was mean of me. I'm sorry. Recently, I know I've been a little down on the series. I think it's just my annoyance with reading manga one chapter a month. Clear cards are the first time I've ever read manga like this. At the height of my manga reading days, before I became a shameless anime-only otaku, I used to have to wait only until the whole book was localized, or I'd be so late to the party that the entire series would already be out and I could just binge it in a weekend. I know that this is how manga is written, but like everyone else, I've been kind of ruined on the streaming style of media consumption. I just want everything now. It's 2019, we've been at this for 2.5 years, and I just need something new to happen. Something unexpected, something fresh, something... Hold on. Ah, that's better. Wait a minute. What the f***?